Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. And in this video, we're gonna learn about permissions in Kotlin Multiplatform, and also we're gonna see how we can take location permission in our KMP applications. So without wasting any time, let's get started. First, go to the description box where you can find my initial project GitHub repository link. Download the project and open up into your Android Studio. Now in this project, I have given you dependencies that I'm gonna use in this project. So in your shared module gradle file, I have added this dependency in my Android main. Now open up your source folder. In this we are having three modules, so let's begin with our common main module. In this I'm gonna create a directory, and the directory name is permission. And in this permission I'm gonna create an interface. Interface name is permission, location permission. In this interface we are having two functions. The first function is permission granted. So with the help of this we can check the status, and return type of this thing is boolean. Next we are having a function which actually used to ask to our user to grant permission. So I'm gonna call this a request location permission. Because this interface is totally devoted for location permission, due to that reason I'm using a request location permission. And in this I'm gonna pass a lambda, and the lambda is granted. And in this the input of the lambda is boolean and output is unit. Okay, so this is our interface, and now it's time to implement this interface in our both platforms for Android and iOS. So let's begin with our Android. So in our Android main module I'm gonna create a package, and the package name is permission. And in this package I'm gonna create a class, and the class name is Android location permission. This class will eventually implement location permission. In this we are having two different functions, so simply implement those functions, is permission granted and location request permission. Now in this class I'm gonna pass two things. So first I'm gonna pass the context, and next I'm gonna pass activity launcher. Type would be activity result launcher, and in this type is string. Okay, so now it's time to implement is permission granted. So for this I'm gonna use my context compat, check self permission, and in this I'm gonna pass my context. And one more thing, we have to add the permission in our manifest. So for that, open up your Android app, open up your source. In this we are having manifest. Now here I'm gonna add all of my permission that I want. So first permission is access course location, next permission is access find location. So these two permission I want. Now go to your Android location permission, and here the next parameter that we have to pass is permission. So for that I'm using your Android. In this manifest permission, and I want access find location permission. Simply return this thing. If it is equals to our package manager dot permission granted, that means we are having the permission, and I'm simply return this thing. If we don't have the permission, what we gonna do? We simply request the location permission. So for that I'm gonna use my activity launcher and launch the activity. In this we have to pass our location permission, Android manifest permission and access find location. Alright, so now it's time to use this Android location permission in our Android app. So in your Android app module, open up your Java folder. In this go to your main activity, and here I'm gonna use this Android location permission class. So first I'm going to create my activity launcher. So for that we are having a variable naming launcher, and initialize this thing with remember launcher for activity result. In the contract we are gonna use activity result contracts dot, because we want to request permission, that's why I'm using here request permission. Next I'm gonna create a status naming state which actually used to tell us the status of our permission. So I'm using here remember mutable state of, it's an empty string. Now it's time to begin with our user interface. So for that I'm using here column, and this column have a modifier of fill max size, its vertical arrangement on the center. Similarly for horizontal I'm using here center horizontally. So in this we are having two things. First we are having a text which actually use our status to tell us the status of our permission. Next we are having spacer to provide some space, and I want a space of 12 dp. Import this dp. Just below to it I'm having a button, and in this button my UI says give permission, And when user click to this button, I'm gonna use my Android location permission here. So for that, we have to use Android location permission. In this, we have to pass context. So for the context, I'm gonna use my local context.current. Pass your context over here. Next, we have to pass our activity launcher. So for that, on the top, we are having launcher. Simply pass it. All right, so we are pretty much done with our very basic location permission composable. Now, when user gives permission, here we are receiving a boolean. So I'm gonna check this boolean. If this boolean is true, that means we are receiving the permission. Now it's time to update our status. So in order to update our status state, make this thing on the top. And now I'm gonna update my status value. So if it is true, that means permission is granted. If it is false, I'm gonna use here denied. All right, so we are pretty much done with our Android permission. Now it's time to execute our Android application. Okay, so our app is executing. Now when I click give permission, I'm not using here request location permission. All right, so now I'm gonna re-execute my application. All right, so now when I click give permission, see, this is our permission, and I'm gonna give the permission and see, permission is granted. So by using this, you can take the location permission in your Android application. Now it's time to begin with our iOS approach. So for that, open up your shared iOS main module, and in this, I'm gonna create few things. So first, I want a directory over here, and the directory name is permission, and in this permission I'm gonna create a class, and the class name is iOS location permission. This class extend location permission. Now it's time to override two functions, is permission granted and request location permission. So in iOS application, we are having CL location manager class, and this class is actually used to manage all of the locations things. So first I'm gonna create my location manager with the help of CL location manager. Now first I'm gonna check the status of the permission. So for that, I'm gonna create a variable naming status with the help of location manager. In this, we are having a function authorization status. So this will give us the status of the permission. Now, if our status is equivalent to KCL authorization status authorize always, that means we are having the access, or our status is equivalent to KCL authorization when in use, on that case we are having the permission. So by using is permission granted, you can check whether permission is granted or not. Now it's time to request the location permission. So first I'm gonna create a status naming variable, and with the help of our location manager dot authorization status, first we will take the status. Next we will check the status. So if our status is KCL authorization not determined, I mean this one, if it is not determined, on that case we're gonna ask the permission. Else other case we are having the permission. So I'm gonna use here granted invoke and pass it true. Now it's time to request the permission. So for that, I'm going to create one more class over here, location manager delegate. In this I'm gonna pass a lambda, and the lambda name is granted. In this, the input is boolean and output is unit. Next, I want to extend this thing with NS object, and also I want to implement one interface, and the interface name is CL location manager delegate protocol. So in iOS, protocol means an interface. In this, we are having a lot of functions. So for me, I'm gonna use here a location manager. Make sure to use location manager that has did change authorization status. And in this, we're gonna check did change authorization status. If the type is KCL authorization status authorize always, or KCL authorization status authorize when in use, on that case we're gonna use granted and invoke it with true because we are having the permission. Else we will use granted and invoke it with false. Now it's time to use location manager delegate. So for that, we are having location manager. In this, we are having delegate. Now it's time to initialize our location manager delegate class and pass our granted in it. Lastly, you can use location manager and request the location when in use authorization. Remove this to do, and we are pretty much done with our iOS location permission. Now it's time to open iOS application in Xcode. So for that, let me open up my Xcode. All right, so first I'm gonna create a variable, and the variable name is location permission, and I'm gonna initialize this thing with iOS location permission. And also I want here a state, so private variable, and I'm gonna call this is granted. Type is boolean, and I'm gonna initialize this thing with false initially. And in order to make this thing as a state, use here annotation state. So when our wish tag appears, I'm gonna update my is granted state. So for that we are having is granted, and in this we are having location permission. This location permission contain a function is permission granted, so it will simply update my is granted state. Now below I'm gonna create a function, and the function name is request location permission. We're gonna use location permission, request location permission. In this lambda we are receiving a boolean, so I'm gonna call this is granted. Now it's time to update our state. Now state is executing on the main thread, so for that we have to use main thread here. So for that we are having a dispatch queue. In the dispatch queue we are having main. In this we are having async. Now it's time to update our is granted state. So for that I'm using yourself is granted, and update this thing with our is granted that we are receiving here in this function. So this is granted is a Kotlin boolean type. So in order to make this boolean type that is acceptable by iOS, you can use your bool value. So now it's time to begin with our wish tag. So in the wish tag we are having text. So this text is dependent to our is granted variable. So if is granted is true, on that case permission is granted. Else we don't have permission, so we simply call it denied. Now just below to it we are having a button. For the UI, I'm gonna replace this button with give permission. And when we perform action, so in the action what we're gonna do, we're gonna simply call request location permission. And yeah, we are pretty much done with our iOS application. Now it's time to execute this iOS app. So go to your Android Studio, select iOS application and execute it. All right, so our app is executing. Initially we don't have permission, so click on this give permission. See this pop-up, and I'm gonna allow this once. See, permission is granted. So by using this approach you can take the location permission in both iOS and Android platform with the help of KMP. So yeah, that's it for this video. If you like this video, subscribe my channel so that I will make more videos. Goodbye, have a nice day.